Welcome back, students. Today we are going to see another topic, that is transgenic animals. So let's start session. Animals which have been genetically engineered to contain one or more genes from an exogenous source, they are called as transgenic animals. Now trans means within two, you can say bodies, and genic you can say at a level of genes. So when there is exchange of genes at an between two, in you can say individuals, or you can say any species, they are called as transgenic. So when it is between animals, it is transgenic animals. So animals which are genetically modified, you can say they are basically called as transgenic animals. Now transgenes are integrated into the genome. That means animal have specific genes for specific characters. So these genes are integrated into the genome of that animal, and due to this they are called as transgene. Now these transgenes can be transmitted through a germline to the progeny. That means you can give, or you can say integrate the particular genome into the parent, and again you can observe that these characters which are used, you have inserted, or you can say incorporated into the parent, they are observed in the progenies also. Okay, so the first transgenic animal which was produced was called as founder animal. Okay, now the process of creating the animals, these transgenic animals, involve major three steps. First is obtaining the embryos, second is micro injecting these embryos, and culturing and transforming into zygotes. So the transgenic integration is expressed by the animal of the desired trait. Whatever trait you are want to incorporate into that animal, that of that genes, it is integrated into that particular animal, and you can just observe the character after that. As you can see in this, that first of all, the genes which are responsible for the particular traits of the disease susceptibly are chosen and extracted, then they are injected into the fertilized mouse eggs, and after that these embryos is implanted into the surrogate mother of, you can say, mice. And after that, they will be expressed by some other offspring because of the transgenic trait character by their DNA. So these character first were integrated into the egg. These egg were, you can say, implanted into the uterus of the mice. And when this mice gives to the birth of young one, you can just see, suppose this is the desired character, or you can say trait, you would like to observe in the, or you can say whatever desired trait you would like to see in the animal, which is observed in that trait. Okay, next come another example of the transgenic animal is of the sheep dolly, in which what happened, the embryo was created by in vitro fertilization. In vitro means it is done in the lab level. So the DNA gene for the drug plus the mammary directing the signal into the fertilized embryo. So whatever desired character was which was observed in this, it was implanted into the fertilized embryo. This embryo was implanted into the surrogate mother, and again the transgenic offspring, you can say, produces the drug in the milk. Suppose if you want to produce a milk which contains a particular drug, so what will happen, what you have to do, that DNA gene which is having that drug, it is implicated into the egg, and that egg is implanted into that surrogate mother, and when this mother give rise to the offspring will ultimately produce a milk which is producing that drug. Okay, so students, in this session we have seen about the transgenic animals. In further session we will have a look on transgenic plants. Thank you.